Hello everybody. In today's video, I'd like to share with you how to convert simple file operations that we are used to making our RPG programs to SQL. So you'll be able to create your RPG programs with embedded SQL. Well, the first thing I want to say is that you are not going to have better performance in your program just doing this. To get better performance, you will need to do all the things. For example, preparing your database for using it in a correct way, creating always the correct index for accessing to you every table, creating the relations between the different tables, and so on. And then you will need to think in every case how to access the data, etc. Well, as you see, it is not as simple as changing a few instructions, so you have to take care of it. Okay, let's go. As always, this is a very simple example. So, of course, there are other ways to do this, okay? Let's go to VS Code. This is an RPG program that I have made with a few instructions using two physical files, as you see. I'm going to convert all the program to SQL, okay? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is to copy this program with all the name, copy, paste, and let me change the name, change the name, SQL test one. And I have to change also my the extension, so the compiler knows that I'm going to use SQL functions. Okay, so let's put it here. Yes, okay. I don't need it anymore. So I will have here my old program with files declared and so on. And I will have here my program in SQL. Well, the first thing I'm going to do, and I will need to do always in when I'm writing an SQL program, an RPG program with embedded SQL, okay? I'm going to set my options of commitment control, okay? So, for this example, I'm not going to use it, so let me set it. SQL set option commit known because I'm not going to use it. Okay, if you want to use commit control and know how to do it, you can check here up in this link and you will see another video talking about it. Okay, well, the first instruction I need to convert is this. And this is just a select, as you see, okay? What I need to do is select. I'm going to retrieve the description from this file, okay? I can use the same name of the field, or I can use a large name if it has. Okay, let's do this way. TypeScript into here. I have to put here the variable customer from. This is the file that I'm going to use, where customer ID. ID is equals ID, okay? If I want to know if the select has been well done, I can see if SQL code is zero or not. If SQL code is zero, then I will have the customer. customer. Okay, if not, I can say not found. Okay, so this is done. This is the old chain, and this is the new chain. Okay. The next instruction is like a join between two tables. So if you see, I have an order number. With the order number, I get the order, and with the customer ID that I have in the order, I can get the customer, and then I have the name of the customer. Okay. Well, this can be done in other ways, but let's do it this way. So, let's do it. Okay, so exec SQL select. Let's put a C in the customer's script into customer. Well, I will need two tables, customers C and CDV orders O, where O order ID, I don't remember, order ID, as you see, order ID is equals to order type, and oops, all customer ID. Yes, customer ID. All customer ID is equals to C. Customer ID also do. Let me see. Customer ID. Again, use ID or customer ID is the same. Okay. ID, for example, it is the same as I say. Okay. And if SQL code is zero, I can display the customer. If not, not found. So I have, this is the new join between the two tables. Okay. Well, the next thing I have to convert is this operation, is just counting the number of records in the table. It is very easy to do. I just need to make a select with count. Select count. Let me use asterisk. I'm not, I prefer not to use the asterisk in a select in embedded SQL, because I will not need only fields most of cases. Okay, so number, let me go here, let's to number from customers. Okay, and well, this way I'm going to have the number of records. In this case, this is the old and the new piece of code. Okay, now the next is adding data to the table. This is very easy to do. So this is just let me customer example exec SQL insert into customers alias. Well, customers has this structure. As you see, I have only two fields, and the first one is automatic, so I will not need to add a value for it, just telling the system that I want to use the default and the description that I have to give. Okay, so in this case, I will put here default and the customer. Okay, so as you see, I have this is the old, this is the new. Okay. Okay, now I'm retrieving data from in a loop, displaying the fields in every time I make a loop. Okay. I will need a cursor in this case, SQL clear, C1 for example, cursor or select ID and description from customers. Okay. That's it. And now I have to open it, open C1. Let's close it after, close C1. And all the operations have to be between them. Okay, and what I have to do while making now a loop using SQL code to control execsql. Now I'm going to make a fetch of the cursor into, as I'm making a select of two fields, I'm going to put it into two different variables. I have them here declared, okay. ID customer. Okay. If SQL code is different than zero, that means that I have not read anything, so I have to leave. And let me put here ID and customer. Yes, customer. As I have it here. In this case, the new piece of code is a little longer, as you see. Well, and okay, and the last thing I want to show you is how to do this piece of code. I'm making the same loop as before. But I'm putting every record I'm reading, I'm putting it into a data structure, okay? So let me convert it, and you will see it's a little different than before. So let me do it, but this must be put, because I'm using an auto structure, okay? So if I set the elements to zero, the structure will be empty. Okay. So execsql as I did before. Okay. Let me copy this because it is the same. I need to put a different name for the cursor, okay, because it is not possible to put the same, okay. Okay, the difference is that, that declare is completely the same, the open of the cursor is the same, But this is different. Okay, I only need to make a simple fetch, and the maximum number of rows I'm going to read at the same time will be 1,000, because the data structure is created with maximum of 1,000 elements. Okay, so I will read the maximum with a simple fetch C2 for the number of rows, okay, into data. That's it. With this simple fetch, I'm getting 1,000 rows maximum into the data structure at the same time. So I don't need to do all this loop, okay? And as this data structure is an auto data structure, I can read the number of elements this way. So it is very cool. That is all the thing to do. I don't need to declare the files now, because I'm using SQL. So that's it. I have the program completely made with embedded SQL. Okay, the two programs do the same thing. Okay, but they are written in a very different way. So you can choose. As I said before, take an eye to the performance. A batch creator select can make your programs and your system slower. Okay. Thanks for watching.